Thank you for staying with us. It's Sunday Politics right here on your the nation's news leader, Channels Television, and we're reaching you live from our studios there in Lagos. Of course, you know what everybody is talking about, the Supreme Court judgment. We saw in Port Harcourt today that the PDP is in the mood of rejoicing over what has come now as the verdict of the Supreme Court saying that Governor Seriake Dixon is, I beg your pardon, Governor of River State, Nyesom Wike, Governor of Akwa Ibom, Governor Udom Emmanuel, has been duly elected. And of course, I meant to say that Governor Seriake Dixon of Bayelsa State was also at that event. But a lot of controversy over the issue of the Supreme Court judgment. My colleague Larry Lasisi, start with the national chairman of the APC. And he said that his party is shocked about the outcome of the Supreme Court. And this is what he said.
When you have such results that are dramatically opposite to my expectation as a person, to the party's expectations, to even the expectations of Nigerians generally, that there's no doubt about, then it calls for worry. As party leader, national chairman, of course I am worried. We have lost Taraba. Is it Labour Party or whichever it was has lost Abia. We have lost Rivers. We have lost Akwa Ibom. We had already, of course, lost Delta. That becomes very, very worrisome, especially, let me emphasize, under circumstances where expectations were different. But it is, at this stage, difficult to pronounce. I was in a state of shock, that one must say. One was in a state of shock, we needed explanations, needed introspection, and until the court now gives us the reasons for these decisions, every other thing we say is speculation. So we'll just be patient. It has dealt the party, so to speak, a body blow from which we have to rebuild quickly. We have to start the process of reinstilling confidence in our followers that there isn't something sinister going on. We have even been accused in Bayelsa, Akwa Ibom, Rivers, that we have sold out deliberately to appease some whatever interest and things like that. So it has given us a tremendous amount of work to do. There may be things we have left undone and points of law that we have left untidied up and the rest of it. So until we hear that, but everybody must know that these are landmark decisions that are going to affect the political landscape. And so the reasons must be pretty weighty. Why should I call for a probe? What are you probing? There's nothing to probe. Okay, I never did that, by the way. I mean, the statement that was issued is clear. There was absolutely no such thing as calling for a probe of the judiciary. And let me make this, my major disappointment is that relatively decent, right-thinking people have stuck to just the headline. And I've made copious comments just based on a caption, a miscaption that came from somebody's excessively fertile imagination.
Chief John Oyegun, APC National Chairman, talking to my colleague there, Larry Lasisi, on the Supreme Court judgments. Some of them are not in favor of the APC, and that is why he said is worried. Well, I have joining me in the studio now a former aide to former president Goodluck Jonathan. Dr. Doyin Okupe joins us now. Many thanks for coming on the program.
Hello, Shem.
Before we delve into this matter, let me ask you, there's been a lot of talk about money spent for the campaign which you're very much part of, the campaign of the PDP in 2015. A lot of people are in court presently, as we talk about money spent, money is given. I'm very sure that you are aware about the Dasuki Gate. Did you collect any money?
No, I didn't.
And you were part of that. You organized a lot of things.
Yes, I did.
And you didn't spend any money.
No, no. When you said, did I collect money from Dasuki for... I didn't really take part actively in the campaign, so to speak. You know, during the campaign, I restricted my activities to what my primary assignment was, which was, you know, looking at the perception of my principal, his public image, and public issues. I really did not, you know, because you see, from experience, I knew that you cannot have a cacophony of voices speaking on the same issues. So I deferred to authorities that have been well laid down and established, and I moved back a bit.
So the monies that you used that time, where was the
funding? No. I didn't take part in the campaign. I worked severally, you know, you're talking about prior to the campaign. So, you know, naturally I was funded from various sources. People gave us money, friends gave us money. We designed a program, we gave it to the president. We called one or two friends, they sponsored it. So most of the things I did were sponsored.
Sponsors that we, of course, may be hearing details maybe later?
Not likely.
Okay. All right, let's go to the matter. The Supreme Court judgment, you heard what Chief Oyegun said, that his party is worried about this. Of course, we do not really know the details of what the Supreme Court actually came to the point where they came on to agree on those verdicts. But when you got the information, the news about those verdicts, how did it come to you?
Well, you know, when you go to court, it's one of two things. It's either you win or you lose. Somebody is going to win, somebody is going to lose. That is why when you go to a court, you will see that effigy that is, you know, in front of the court, a lady with a sword on one side and a scale of justice on the other side. Her eyes are blindfolded. So he doesn't see anybody. He judges according to law. It's supposed to be so. You know, I had Chief John Oyegun, a very respected elder and somebody that he knows I love him and I hold him in one of the highest esteem. And that is why I am shocked that he was shocked. And, you know, I heard just now where he was trying to make a rebuttal that he did not ask the Supreme Court to be judges to be probed. He even said something worse.
He has denied saying so.
Yeah, he said he didn't ask them to be, but he said, you know, as far as he's concerned, the judgment is still speculation. You can't say the judgment of the Supreme Court of Nigeria.
He said the reactions are speculation.
No.
The details of the judgments are not out yet.
He said because the details of the judgments are not out now, as far as they are concerned, the judgment is still a speculation. I just heard it now. That's ridiculous, absolutely ridiculous. And it cannot come from an elder statesman like that, holding a very responsible, the leader of the party in government. You see, people do not understand something. When a policeman accosts me on the road and tells me to get out of my car and I get down, I'm older than him, richer than him, better than him, it is not for him that I am getting down. I'm getting down for the law that he represents. Today, you know, his party is in government because we recognize, and people of Nigeria and the world recognize, the law that establishes the presidency. So when you remove that law and you disregard that law, or undermine or demean it, you are destroying your own very existence. Oyegun should know better than that. It doesn't make sense. You cannot say you are shocked.
You condemn the way he reacted. Is that what you're saying?
No, the things he said with his mouth, the postulates are wrong. You know, he even said that, you know, he reduced the whole thing to mercantilism. He says that Akwa Ibom is gone, Rivers is gone, this one is gone, these are the all rich states. Excuse me. I mean, you know, if you are not popular in an all-rich state, must you win there? And, you know, he kept on talking about our expectations. Your expectations are not the legal expectations of the Supreme Court judges. While you expect or you are expecting victory based on your need, political need, the gentleman, you know, the judges, the respectable judges in the Supreme Court must adjudicate according to law.